Hi, my name is Leland Taylor, and I graduated from Fairdale back in 1992. From there, I went on to go to the University of Tennessee. Then I went from there and went on to the University of Louisville. After that, I played for the Baltimore Ravens, but I broke my leg and my foot in a car wreck. After that, I worked a little bit. Then I decided to open my own restaurant. So now I own my own restaurant. It's in Shively, called Wing Station. The teacher that inspired me most was probably a teacher, Mr. Miles. He was the African-American history teacher. And he just always instilled in me just to do the right thing, and he would pull me to the side. And, I remember one time he told me, he said, I always do what right, no matter who's watching, because you never know, and that stuck with me a lot, and that stuck with me in the business that I'm doing now. I always try to do my best and take pride in my work, because you never know who's watching. Thank you.
My name is Mwamini Mulungula, and I was class of 2020 at Fairdale High School. I have a gifted talent of dancing and singing, especially with African cultures. A person that recently inspired me is Amanda Gorman. I listened to her poem, and she said something that really stood out to me. She said, "We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be. A country that is bruised, but whole. Benevolent, but bold, fierce, and free." She is basically speaking on shaping the future of young Americans. And me being a young Black girl in America has shown me the difficulties and disadvantages of growing up being Black. A lot of events has happened that has shaped people's mindsets on each other. But listen to her poem touches base on uniting people and people coming together no matter the circumstance.
Hey everyone, and happy Black History Month. I'm Dwayne Kent, as well as I graduated with class of 2012. Almost 10 years ago, which is a long time. I'm also the acting class president of 2012. I graduated from Western Kentucky University with a behavior science degree. As of right now, I do live in Orlando, Florida, and I love it here. As well as I am the founder and president of the ARC Network Group, which allow women to buy or sell products with up to a 20% discount or services as well. One of the things that inspired me to go on my entrepreneur journey or to launch my own business at such an early age was my dad. Actually, he's one of the dominant figures in my family, one of the dominant figures in our community today. And the reason I say that is because he donates $1.3 million a year for Black families and Hispanic families for scholarships in education and as well as in business, in nursing, as well as he owns his own company, which is CMR, which is a MSO company as well, and is worth more than $40 million as of today. As well as he used to work for Humana and be the regional CEO and president for all Florida-based Humana-owned medical centers. A couple other things about him is he owned his own book publishing company. So he wrote his own book called Wow Moments. And the reason I mention these things is because, like, he's the closest person to me. And I watch my dad, this man, grow our family. And I want to be just like him. So, again, my dad is the man who inspires me and make me want to do more. So I hope this helped, and happy Black History Month.
My name is Tanaya Phipps, and I'm a junior at Fairdale High School. The person I chose for Black History Month is Henry Tanner, and he is the first African-American painter to be known internationally. Henry Tanner had to deal with a lot of racism in society, and it was very hard on him, but painting always was therapeutic to him, so it really helped him during these times. Henry Tanner accomplished many things and gotten many art exhibits in Paris. He inspires me because I really like to paint. I don't do it as much as I would like to, but I really love it, and it's also very therapeutic to me, and it can help me a lot sometimes. I painted this one thing a couple weeks ago that I'm gonna show y'all, and it's the first thing I painted without like an outline, so. This is my painting, and this is actually the first painting I've done where I have to draw it and paint it myself, and I'm very proud of it, even though it could be better, but it was my first one, so yeah. And that's why he inspires me, because even though he went through rough times with racism, he still kept going on.
Patricia Bath was born on November 4th, 1942, in New York City's Harlem neighborhood. She was the first African-American woman to complete a residency in ophthalmology at New York University in 1986. The same year, she invented the laser focal probe, harnessing laser technology. The device created a less painful and more precise treatment of cataracts. She received a patent for the device in 1988, becoming the first African-American female doctor to receive a patent for a medical purpose. She also holds patents in Japan, Canada, and Europe. She was able to restore the sight of people who had lost their eyesight for more than 30 years. She was named Howard University Pioneer in Academic Medicine, Women Who Changed the World by Time magazine, inducted to the International Women in Medicine Hall of Fame, and appointed as Commissioner for Digital Accessibility for the Blind by Barack Obama. Not only did she greatly impact the medical world, but she has helped open and pave many ways for Black women like you and me in the medical world.
Hello, my name is Lamar Tandy, and I am a senior at Fairdale High School. The person who I would like to shout out, that he's my inspiration, he's the person I look up to the most, is Tupac Shakur. He's one of the best-selling music artists, well, back in the 90s. Tupac was more than an artist to me. He was a poet, a speaker, a person who talks about real-life things other than his rap. He talked about how we was getting treated unfairly, how we was getting judged by other people and everything. So that's why I fell in love with the image of Tupac. And one thing that he most inspired me was with this poem called "The Rose That Grew From Concrete," which really interprets a kid just like me, who rose, who people judge because my rose was dirty. My rose wasn't really perfect like everybody. And I can make them, like he said, you can make them laugh, happy, smile, even cry, like, but they still would judge you by how your rose is. And that really inspired me to, like, it really inspired me to, like, do better. Like, prove them wrong that my rose can be more than just, you feel me? My rose can be more than just dirty. It can be bright. It can be lovable. It can be the best, the greatest.
Hi, I am Alexis Marshall, and I'm a senior at Fairdale High School, and my inspiration is an African-American female track and field athlete named Wilma Rudolph. Wilma Rudolph was an American sprinter born in St. Bethlehem, Tennessee, who became a world record-holding Olympic champion and international sports icon in track and field following her successes in the 1956 and 1960 Olympic Games. Wilma Rudolph used her success to elevate women's athletics, and she did a lot to promote women's entry into other Olympic sports and in development of women's athletic programs throughout the world. Wilma Rudolph also used her fame as a platform to fight for civil rights along with other Black athletes, including Muhammad Ali. She advocated for equal rights. She inspired me as an athlete to not give up and keep working hard. Wilma Rudolph did not have an easy life growing up because she was born with polio, a disease that causes paralysis, and despite being told she would never walk again, she continued to pursue her dream of becoming an international track and field athlete. Track and field is not an easy sport, but I really enjoy the competition of racing another athlete. Wilma Rudolph will remain a female icon for all women and color track and field athletes.
I run track and field and cross country. Here are a few photos from my 2020 cross country season.
Fairdale High School students. My name is Tiana Forrest, and I am alumna of one of the best classes to ever step foot in Fairdale, class of 2012. I'm also proud alumna of Northern Kentucky University. Go Norths! I'm currently a stay-at-home mom to a three-month-old baby boy named Corbin, and I'm a graduate student at Western Kentucky University, where I'll be graduating this May with my Master of Arts in Education School Counseling degree, with plans of becoming a high school counselor, with the goal of helping students just like you become better academically, socially, and emotionally to become productive citizens once they leave the four walls of high school. Who inspires me is no other than Queen B, Beyonce herself. I am a huge Beyonce fan. I love her. I love what she represents. I love her music. I love how she just entertains. But the reason why she inspires me is because she's a hard worker. She's dedicated to perfecting her craft. And that's something I aspire to do. I aspire to be a hardworking woman. And I aspire to be dedicated to and always perfect
my Fairdale students. I'm Kirsten Finch.
My name is Larry Finch.
And we are a class of 2011.
So nice we had to say it twice.
The college that we attended was
Indiana University Southeast,
JCTC,
and Sullivan.
Our current occupation.
Right now I'm currently an accounting specialist for JBS, a pork producer that's in the eastern of Louisville.
I am a transaction processor for a stock trading company. Who has currently inspired us? It's Black History Month, so who inspired you?
Barack Obama. I'd say Barack Obama simply because he has shown that change is possible. It really just takes hard work, determination, persistence, but you can do it. I think he's been a really good inspiration to it. How about you?
Good. Okay. The person that has inspired me is Madam CJ Walker. Not only was she a social activist, she was a successful entrepreneur who struggled with a scalp condition that inspired her to make products for African Americans to maintain healthy hair growth and versatility since our hair is so unique. So with it being February, yes, it is Black History Month, so this is a good time to sit back and think about who has inspired you and also to do your research.
I'd like to thank Ms. Kinzer for contacting us. We were more than happy to help in any way possible. We just want to say go dogs. This is the class of 2021.
Mm-hmm.
It's been 10 years for us.
It has been 10 years. And we just want to encourage all of you students to just keep going, stay focused, do your research, take tons of notes, and always ask questions.
Knowledge is power.
Alyssa, I graduated from Fairdale in 2012. After I graduated, I took off to college. I graduated from U of L in 2018 with my bachelor's degree in special education and general education. The person who inspires me, her name is Miss Calloway. She was my fifth grade teacher. She is the teacher who just really showed me that I have a lot of potential. She never let me slack off. I was kind of a bad kid. She never let me slack off. She made sure that I did all of my work. She made me feel like I could do great things in this world, and then that's what I went and did. So,
yeah. My name is Christine Bellance, and I am a current senior at Gatton Academy and Fairdale High School. So two salient figures in my life that have very much so inspired me are Michelle Obama and Katherine Johnson. Michelle Obama has inspired me since I was a little girl, and she shows for me especially that Black women are capable of the leadership positions and just being able to see that I am capable to uplift myself and achieve every single goal I've set forth. And Katherine Johnson has really shown me in the STEM field that if there's never a seat for me, to pull up a chair and make one at the table, And that's really shown me that I hold the power of my future and that it's all in my hands. And just being capable to, even if there isn't a vast majority of us in these fields or holding these occupations, to be able to see that I'm able to have one, it's really important. And to see that someone has done it and I'm able to achieve it as well. So some of my achievements have been becoming a Bill Gates semifinalist and also a National Security Language Initiative for Youth semifinalist at this moment. So for both of those, I am still in the phase of being a potential finalist, and Bill Gates would offer me additional full ride and pay for any other additional needs I have. Nestle offers me to have intensive study in Arabic, which is a language I plan on continuing in college. And past that, I've also become a QuestBridge National College Match finalist and a College Match recipient to University of Chicago. And that program has given me a full ride, no parent contribution, for Chicago as well. And it's just been really awesome to see that throughout my life, all these achievements, sacrifices that my family has made as well, from coming to Haiti to America, becoming a first gen, shows that I'm able to utilize all of this and be able to achieve such a high stature that I currently have has been really awe-inspiring, and I continue to do more, and every day I am grateful.
Hi, my name is Sierra Battle, and I graduated from Fairdale in 2016. My success is graduating from the University of Louisville and becoming a registered nurse. I want to shout out Dr. Ashley Anderson, who is a Black women's health nurse practitioner here in Louisville, Kentucky, and she's the co-founder of her very own women's practice called Athena Health and Wellness. And Dr. Anderson has inspired me since the very first day I met her 4 years ago to want to open my own practice as a certified nurse midwife. And I am so excited. I'm about a month away from taking the first step needed for me to reach that goal. I will be going overseas to work as a nurse in labor and delivery for 6 months, and I'll be able to gain all the knowledge and experience I need to be able to come back and provide care that is appropriate and necessary for the Black community and the African community here in the city. So thank you so much, Dr. Ashley Anderson. Thank you so much, Mrs. Flora Ponder, for everything that you have done and for paving the way for Black nursing students and Black nurses.
Sometimes I wish you knew, but I disguise the truth. I say I'm happy, but I'm still stuck on us. Does your mind play this game too? Think about me and you. I guess I'll just pretend until it all makes sense. See you face to face, I'm thinking about the days we used to be. But I can't make a scene. But I can't make a scene. See you face to face, I'm thinking about the days we used to be. But I can't make a scene. But I can't make a scene. Like I want you. Even if it's true.
Hello everyone, my name is Cedric Kia. I am a graduate of Fairdale High School. I graduated in 2016 as part of the first Cambridge graduating class. So I had a great experience at Fairdale. I definitely enjoyed my time there. After high school, I was fortunate enough to attend the University of Louisville, where I studied math and history education in hopes of becoming a school teacher. I graduated in 2020. I graduated in May of 2020, and I quickly transitioned into my teaching career as a math teacher, where I'm currently teaching at Ramsey Middle School right now as a math teacher there, and I'm enjoying every moment of it. I'm enjoying the many memories that I'm making with my students. And I'm also looking forward to creating those relationships that will last forever. I'm looking forward to impacting not only the students at my school, but students throughout the community as well. As we approach Black History Month, I like to reflect on a couple of things. I like to reflect on a few historical figures that impacted my life personally. Also, just looking at some community members who also inspired me to get to the position that I am today. And there's no better place to start than Fairdale's own Miss Kinsler. Miss Kinsler played a great part in my life and my career choice and career path as well. I remember always just thinking about how Miss Kinsler was one of the first, one of the few African American teachers that I had in my school career. And you know, that definitely means a lot to be able to go to class and see someone who looks like you. It definitely makes a difference. So just talking to her and receiving a lot of advice from her, I was able to make the decision to study out education and seek out a career in teaching. Another great person who inspired me, another Fairdale Zone, is Mr. James. Mr. James helped me to realize that there's so much more that I can do as a Black male in America. I don't have to strive for what the media tells me. I don't have to strive for what society is telling me where I would end up as a Black man. Just seeing him as a Black male teacher at Fairdale, he also taught math as well. So that inspired me a lot to go after that career. Also, it showed me that I'm able to become something. I'm able to do something that I definitely love, and I'm able to impact so many lives, because they definitely impacted my life. So Ms. Kinsler and Mr. James are the two community figures that I can say definitely inspired me as a Black man in America. And when I think of historical figures in America that inspired me, there's so many of them. You know, there's the great figures that we're all familiar with. You know, the Ali's, the Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, and all that. Yes, they've inspired me, but the one that really sits close to home is Woodford Porter. Mr. Porter was part of the community as well, and he was the first African-American to be elected into the Louisville Board of Education in 1959. And he was also elected to become the president of the Board of Trustees for the University of Louisville. And it's amazing to see the great accomplishments that he was able to achieve during that time, the time of so many difficulties in this country. And that inspires me as a Black man to see that, wow, you know, he's able to do these things, these amazing things during that time. How much more can I do in this era? I mean, we're in 2021, hoping things progressively get better. So it gives me the motivation to always want to achieve more, to do better, and to help the community, to help the people around me. Because Mr. Porter definitely helped me out in so many areas. In fact, the only reason I was able to attend the University of Louisville was because of a scholarship, the Porter Scholarship, which was named after Porter. And you know, I was grateful for that, and it impacted my life tremendously. So I would like to really just say thank you to all of these amazing Black figures that have impacted me, whether directly or indirectly, as we're celebrating Black History Month. You know, we always want to continue to follow the legacy of these amazing people, and that's my goal as an educator as well. I want to make sure that I'm impacting the lives of people who are struggling, minority students who are looking for someone to look at as a role model, for minority students who are looking at someone as a teacher to help them, to lead them, to guide them, to show them that they do matter, to show them that they can become something more than what society is telling them that they'll become. So again, as we celebrate Black History Month, let's keep being grateful for these great figures, and just continue to celebrate the progress that we're making. And also, let's just continue to fight for what these amazing people have been fighting for so many years. Thank you.